And welcome back, everybody. We are going to be going straight to Game 2. But before that, Nada, what are we going to be seeing? Which of these teams are we going to see? Where have we seen them before? And what has happened between the two?
Oh, I feel all famous for you interviewing me. No, we are going to be looking at the legendary 99 Saints team fighting off Team Boss, both two very, very good teams. We've seen these teams fight off a couple of times before in the quarterfinals of the first Inning Warrior Cup, as well as the finals of the No Solar Tournament, if I could English. So these two teams have a history of fighting each other. So it's going to be interesting. 99 Saints has always come out victorious, but who knows, this may be the game where Boz gives them their all and actually takes them down. So I'm so hyped to see this happen.
Let's get right into these two teams actually give each other a run for their money, and we're gonna see Ribbit coming out again. That being said, Nada, give us the picks and bans for this match.
You got it right. So Boz ending up with the first pick is going to ban out Scoop. In return, we're gonna see a Coco ban come out of 99 Saints. So already we have that Scoop and Coco out of the way. Two very, very high tier nauts. So that's gonna allow for a bit more open picking, as both Coco and Scoop counters out quite a few options in terms of picks. So first pick from Boss is going to be Swiggins. Very, very aggressive naut, and I think it fits their playstyle very well. From 99 Saints, the double pick is going to be Scaldier and Ayla, so it makes sense why they do not want that Scoop to fight off. Scoop does a very good job at keeping both Ayla and Scaldier at bay, so it makes really good sense to ban that. So good picking going on there. Double pick coming out of Boss is going to be Froggy G and Genji. So not only are you going to ban the Froggy G from 99 Saints, where Nikki and his legendary frog is not going to be able to wreak havoc today, however, we are going to see Nikki on his Raylan, I assume. Nikki plays a very mean burst-heavy Raylan using the HC bomb. So all in all, it's going to be an interesting matchup. I cannot wait to get this started. So if you are ready, I am going to give you that countdown.
Go for it.
You got it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And coming down, I am assuming we're going to be seeing base abilities come out on most nauts, except for Genji piggying for that extra AA damage and DOT.
Now, tell us a little bit about this Ayla, because we haven't seen Ayla play too much in competitive, but seeing this Ayla coming out on 99 Saints, I think it's going to be very interesting. So talk a little bit about Ayla and how that is going to be able to play into this.
Well, Ayla has, well, if you...
Actually, first off, Nikki, is going to be taking a lot of damage. Both teams getting into the fray right there. Furry is actually going to get picked up in the process, so that is going to be a one-for-one exchange within the first minute of the game, as Evil Soldiers is going to be looking to pick up some health on top. But, as I said before, tell us about Ayla.
Ayla, you just saw how Ayla works well. Scaldier Ayla is a super powerful combo. You get that throw, you apply that Evil Eye slow, and then you go in with the DPS from both turret, Ayla, as well as the DOT from Scaldier's Earthquake. So there is so much damage potential just coming out of a single throw if these two can stay together.
We're actually going to see just the clearing game kind of occur right now, as Whoopi and Evil Soldier in that top lane. Nikki kind of getting into the fray right now, as we see Bad Joe, Burry, and Cannoli all into this midsection. Nikki looking for the snipe, unable to pick anything up with that, and Whoopi looking for a throw, but unable to actually land any of that. And we're going to see Burry going in for that turret dive right now, landing that poke, but Bad Joe getting the FU snipe coming out from Raylan.
Oh yeah, something we should pay attention to here is the bounce throw.
And we just saw right there as Bad Joe was tossed, but unfortunately wasn't into that top section, so it was thrown against the wall into that mid.
Oh yes, the bounce throw is a very, very dangerous, a very, very dangerous strategy to pull off, especially because, to fight against, because it is a very safe throw. You go up, you fly in with a billion miles an hour, you go and you land that throw. If you time it correctly, they will fly straight to your turret and they will have no idea what hit them.
And we see him coming up right there with the Earthquake, unable to make anything of it, but landing the DOT on Genji.
Yeah, that is important. Very, very important. Especially without regen on Genji. Regen on Genji is very good, and he is a null that works very well with Regen. One of the
and we actually null- see them both going in right now as Evil Soldier lands the Evil Eye on Cannoli. He's going to be forced to get back as we see Nikki looking in for the sniper there, getting the double snipe on Bad Joe and Cannoli, and we're going to see the entirety of Team Boss move away from that midsection as we see 99 Cents take their place into that mid. Cannoli looking to see if he can pick anything up, but Whoopi and Nikki down there to make sure that that does not happen, as Evil Soldier is going to clear up this top lane with the entirety of 99 Cents, hoping to clear up these lanes and really start their laning phase and progress to those first two turrets.
Oh yes, the first two turrets on Ribbit, those turrets are, if without doubt, the most, well, the most expendable ones in the entire game. Just because of how close they are to the mid. Getting poking on these turrets is so easy, and one should not feel sad if the two first turrets go down on Ribbit, as the match usually has a way of saying in the first quarter of the game, the first two turrets will go down, and then the last quarter of the game, the last two turrets will go down. So there is going to be this kind of, intermission? I don't know. This little time where no turret is going to go down as the map length increases a lot when the two first turrets are down.
And we're going to see that snipe going down into mid. Nothing able to be picked up from that as we see Nikki getting into the fray right now and the entirety of both teams duking it out up top. Evil Soldier being that great zoning coming out, allowing Nikki to escape. And Nikki just barely picks up that health from the DOT and is able to survive as Whoopi and Evil Soldier go back to their defensive stance.
All right, and we are now starting to see the different...
Huge engagement going on right now as we see both of them in the top lane, as Bad Joe is going to be taking a lot of DOT damage from that earthquake and from that Evil Eye. He's going to be forced to retreat out on bottom as Cannoli is going to be battling it out into this midsection up top with a half a health bar. Battling with a half a health bar in either of these teams is not a good situation. You never want to be below half health with either of these teams because they can collapse so quickly on you. And I'm pretty sure we're going to see it at a later point in this game as Nikki's going to land the quick snipe going off on Commander Burry right there, as he's going to be trying to battle it out with Bad Joe on the bottom right here, but Burry's going to be there. And it looks like Nikki's going to get hooked in from Swiggins, and a snipe coming out is going to be able to hit Bad Joe into that midsection as Team Boss has retaken mid control. And we're going to see a huge engagement coming on right now as Bad Joe's taking a lot of damage. The canceled snipe by Cannoli, a nice dash is going to cancel that snipe coming out on Raylan, securing safety for Bad Joe. Excellent plays by both teams. So talk about, I really just want to discuss how important it is to be in the vicinity of your teammates, whether it be to secure a kill or for safety. And how is that playing an effect in this match?
Well, you have... obviously, when you play a comp that involves either Swiggins or Genji, you want to be with your team just
because... We're actually going to see a huge engagement coming on right now as Evil Soldier looking to pick up a kill, and Nikki going to miss the jump snipe right there. But continue, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, please do. See, the thing about Swiggins and Genji is all this you provide for your
Another
team...
Another huge fight for... actually going on right now as Nikki's going to take a lot of damage into that bottom section.
Yes, yes, yes. That is absolutely true. The whole idea of Swiggins is burst and then constrain. And when you can constrain people, you can, you can do a lot of damage. And then what Genji can do is you keep that level of constrainment up and throw that cocoon out. And that's going to allow Frog to basically go in as hard as he possibly wants and can and will and all those things.
And we're going to see a huge engagement coming on right now. Is that is going to be a double pickup for 99 cents for the exchange of one as Whoopi goes down. Evil Soldier is going to be able to pick up a kill as well. So that is going to be a 2-for-1 exchange coming out on top as 99 Cents takes the kill lead. But that is not to exclude Cannoli right now, who we know his frog. We've seen it before. He's a very strong frog, and he is easily capable of defending both of these lanes while his teammates are taking the drop pod down.
There is a lot of AA damage on Nikki right now, though. And what I want to point out here is his decision to go piggy bank in for that extra damage. I'm sure that it is to get that upper hand. All of a sudden he's spiking his AA up to a pretty high level, getting that ponytail in. It's gonna allow him to push harder, allow him to brawl harder, and in general just play harder.
We're actually going to see them go into this top section right now as the first turret comes down in favor of 99 cents. Boss is going to have to defend decently hard right now, and they get that Genji cocoon off. Whoopi's going to be taking a half chunk of health right now as Bad Joe's looking to make something and pick up Whoopi in the process. Whoopi's going to be able to get out. Cannoli is going to be dealing a lot of damage, and Cannoli is going to pick up this kill on Nikki as we have evened the kill score up at 3-3.
Oh, yes. Oh, Nikki has actually had two deaths, but we don't mind. That was not the first kill.
Look at that upgrade on Raylan.
Oh, HC bomb.
Just picked up.
Oh, that is probably one of the strongest upgrades on Raylan.
One of the strongest upgrades on Raylan. Try one of the strongest upgrades in the game.
Oh, yes. It is going to provide you.
That's a huge damage increase.
It's going to provide you with 3 times the damage of your AA after you throw a Rift. You're going to be able to stack that up by throwing a Rift, waiting for Rift cooldown to come off, and then shoot, Rift, shoot.
But this is going to be a lot of damage coming out, and actually off of his cooldowns is not going to be able to hook in on that bottom section and pick up a kill on Nikki. Nikki has been escaping a lot with very low health as of late, and although he does have 2 kills at this point, he has been able to escape mostly due to his team at this point, but on that time, he was actually all on his own and had to thwart off the entirety of Boss by himself as Evil Soldier goes into his top section to try and look for something to clear. They've kind of separated from Team Boss in regards to Team Boss is sticking together. They're leaving Nikki in this bottom lane for Whoopi and Evil Soldier to defend in that top. A nice snipe coming out from Nikki up there as we're still going to follow around Evil Soldier looking for something right now, and the entirety of Team Boss getting that Genji Blessing, holding into that midsection, and really putting in their dominance for mid control.
Oh yeah. See, what I wanna talk about a bit the Genji pick here, because the Genji is going to allow so much countering. Genji is a very underrated pick, and he's one of those nauts that is hard to master, and when you do it, you get so much in return. It has so many perks of having a great Genji player on your team. You get that shield that reduces your damage, you get that cocoon to sort of shut down players with
and the throw notes. Actually coming out right now, and Whoopi is going to be forced to fight out with the Evil Soldier right now. Nice punches landing from Whoopi as Cannoli is going to get picked up by Nikki off the jumper with the AA, and we're going to see Team Boss retreating now, trying to defend, and Nikki landing the snipe on Burry again, forcing Burry to stay into this bottom lane. One of them needs to go back, one of them needs to get an upgrade, one of them needs to get health, and it's going to be Burry at this point as we see Evil Soldier looking to pick up a Solar Boss, a nice extra 20 Solar coming out.
Oh yeah, for each teammate, it's important to note here, that is a total of 60 Solar coming out just by killing that thing, and with an Ayla you can do that quickly, with a Raylan you can do that quickly. So they have a great Solar Boss farming potential on 99 cents side, which is something I'm sure they're gonna be using later in the game when we need to stack up their damage.
And a nice double snipe coming out from Nikki is gonna be able to deal a lot of damage. Cannoli with a lot of damage, and we're gonna see Nikki have a lot of damage right now as Nikki's gonna get picked up by the AA of Cannoli, but we're also gonna see Cannoli trying to look for something else as Burry's gonna get picked up by Evil Soldier in the top lane right there. And we were talking about how important those one-for-one exchanges are, just being able to make the best out of a bad situation and really pick up a kill in a bad time.
Oh yeah, well, that is important, because when you get that kill, when just one kill in these top tier matchups, one kill is gonna mean a hell of a lot more than when you are in solo queue. You're gonna be seeing people push in super hard whenever they have the advantage, and as soon as one player is down, that is a huge advantage, as you're gonna have a third of the team basically unable to do anything for around 20 seconds in these early stages of the game. And that could pretty much mean a turret.
And we're going to see a decent team fight coming out here, probably in the impending few seconds, as Burry's looking to pick something up. Cannoli's going to waste his dash. Here comes the Blessing, pushing out that snipe, but a throw coming out as Burry's going to get thwarted out by the turret. Evil Soldier looking to make the best out of a bad situation, trying to hunt down Cannoli, and he's still chasing. We're going to see Whoopi try and land a throw, but Cannoli actually has his dash back, and Nikki not able, but Bad Joe is actually going to get picked up in the process, as Nikki will get a kill on Bad Joe in front of the turret. We're going to see Frog start to pick up some more dash damage, but that is what we were talking about, how important it is to really be aware and be in the vicinity of your teammates to try and help them. And we saw it there. We saw Genji really try and lay that blessing out. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough for him or his teammate, as Barry did get picked up by the throw against the turret, and Genji got picked up by the snipe coming in on Nikki. And now 99 Cents is going to progress into these last two turrets and try and take them down with vengeance.
Oh, I like that. Turrets down with vengeance. See, we're seeing a very, 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 like, what I like to see from 99 Cents that I don't see many other teams doing is actually, they do so well on their own that they can split up and make really wide team fights. Nikki was cutting off the entire top turret there on Himmel.
We're actually going to see this engagement coming out by from Cannoli right now, and we're going to see a nice cocoon coming out, blocking out the snipe. Here comes the anchor. Here comes Cannoli. Open up the doors, and maybe here's a kill. Nothing coming out just yet, as you're going to see Evil Soldier get into that bottom lane and try and pick up some health. And really, we've seen 99 Cents collapse on Team Boss, but we've also seen Team Boss be very powerful in the aspect of their defending. They're defending each other, making sure that none of them are taking too much damage, and a triple snipe coming out from Nikki right there, as Whoopi's going to be looking to pick something up right now. But I do believe Bad Joe did land his cocoon, but there's still a battle going on in mid right now, as Bad Joe's going to be forced to get back. And Cannoli, actually, look at that health bar. It went down quite a bit. He's going to be forced to go back and get some health. Bad Joe looking to land the cocoon. Does land it on Whoopi, but these droids are pushed into that turret. And we're going to see 99 Cents really establish themselves. A double snipe coming out. Nikki's taking a lot of damage right now. Whoopi with the throw. Burry's looking for the kill on Nikki. Nikki is going to go down to Burry with an extra DOT coming out from Genji, I do believe.
You are absolutely right. And DOT on Genji is actually a really, really good upgrade, especially in the early game, but still does add that extra damage, as it will automatically apply the first tick of the damage as soon as you hit someone. And that's both on the attack and the return of the butterfly.
Evil Soldier going to be forced to defend up top as Whoopi's taking a lot of damage. Evil Soldier able to destroy that, but does get picked up by that cocoon that's going to force Whoopi back to grab some health, as we're going to see Nikki dropping shortly. Evil Soldier forced to defend alone for a few seconds against Team Boss. Team Boss has actually progressed their droids into that bottom turret. I don't think they've actually touched that, but the droids have. And that top turret is actually going to go down. That is going to be the first turret for Team Boss at around the 15-minute marker of the game. Evil Soldier picking up another solar boss. This is just, at this point, another throw coming out. Bad Joe's taking a lot of damage. Bad Joe's going to go down to the turret, and we're going to see 99 Cents progress forward, try to pick up a second kill here as Nikki is hunting down Burry. Burry is going to be forced to go and pick up that health. Whoopi being in that zoning phase right now. Can he get the throw? He does get the throw, and here we see Evil Soldier looking for the kill, and unfortunately for him, Burry is able to escape by hooking up and out away. We're going to see Getting Out of the Hood coming out on Genji. Tell us a little bit about that.
Getting Out of the Hood is, well, as far as I've understood, a lot of people actually misinterpreting this upgrade as an escape upgrade because it's named Out of the Hood. It is indeed a very, very powerful initiation upgrade. It will allow your team to move at, I believe it is 25% faster during the blessing, and that it, no, that's 30%, I'm very sorry, 30% extra speed, and that is going to allow you to really get some fast jukes in. Frog is going to be a lightning, Swiggins is going to get in there without you even knowing, and Genji can get his team out if it is needed. So, a very, very powerful blessing upgrade, and I think it is a must to have in every blessing
build. And Cannoli's actually going to be hunted down by Evil Soldier right now. The dash, I don't know if it's going to be enough for him to escape, but it looks like it is. Nikki looking for the snipe on bottom does manage to land it on Burry, as Bad Joe is going to be taking some damage from the solar boss, but man, this cocoon is going to be so powerful. This Genji playing to the utmost support can really secure these kills.
You're absolutely right. And the most important thing is probably to cancel out either Ayla or Skuldir, in the sense that you can, you know, Skuldir has to commit. That is the thing. He has to commit. And if he does not land his throw, he is in a really bad spot. And you can force him to miss by using that cocoon.
We're going to see this kind of reestablishment of mid-control coming out for 99 Cents. A snipe coming out, hitting Burry on that bottom right there, and a full Rift build. Full Rift, and I'm assuming AA shortly after coming out for Nikki.
You're absolutely right, and this is a very, very scary build. Something I want to point people's attention to is that Nikki is building for the most turret damage, not just the most maximum damage. And that is something that is very important to know, because you're going to be needing that extra turret damage more than the extra naught damage, and it is only one damage to different, like, indifference. So just getting that base damage that's going to apply to both
and
turrets.
Canola's and Canola's actually going to be caught right here, but Nikki looks like he's going to be taking a lot of damage as well. Evil Soldier in for the save. Bad Joe is actually going to be looking to escape right now, as Burry is going to pick up Nikki and the Solar Balls, but Burry is going to be in a bad situation as he's going to be forced to take the Solar Balls very quickly, but the Solar Balls is going to pick him up. Cannoli looking to pick up his Solar, and Evil Soldier waiting him out. Evil Soldier is going to be able to pick up Cannoli. Cannoli making the error of looking for that Solar, and Evil Soldier noticing it and saying, okay, I'll wait you out, no problem.
They actually ended up getting that Solar Boss in the end. That was something.
That was something, all right. We're going to see Spirit Cooking coming out on Genji for that extra HP upon Blessing. And I think that's a very important upgrade.
Oh, yeah. It is, like, it is less important with lower high HP upgrade, but with a frog and fighting so much burst, it's important to try to get as much damage in as possible, and that's what they're going to be able to do. Frog is also the only player on Team Boss right now.
We're actually going to see Nikki get picked up right there in a great engagement. Evil Soldier coming out once again, going to be able to pick up Burry, and Ayla is just becoming a powerhouse right now, leading the pack at 5-0 and as far as kills go, with 550 Solar as of now.
Mm-hmm. Ayla is, as you said, a powerhouse, and with the slow and the size on Rage mode, you can really do wonders. Get that, you know, if someone's in Rift, well, too bad, you're dead. Ayla is going to be there to stack up on top of the Rift damage per second. So it's just, it's so much, so much damage. And it's happening so fast.
And I'm actually taking a look at these Evil Eye upgrades. Those are very powerful Evil Eye upgrades. DOT and increased slow.
Yeah, the slow one, I think, is what is... what is keeping them down. Frog with slow, it's not pretty. Your dash length is going to be reduced. It's just not going to be pretty.
And actually, we're going to see a huge fight going on right now in the bottom as Evil Soldier is able to pick up Cannoli again and looking for the kill on Burry. But Bad Joe is there. Evil Soldier realizes that, and he's going to be forced to kind of get back a little bit and not engage completely. We're actually seeing the Can't Touch This upgrade, the shield coming out. I think that's a very smart upgrade coming out for Cannoli.
I would have actually expected Arbe, but I totally get where he's coming from with this upgrade.
We're now Arbe seeing Evil Soldier kind of get into that bottom section, but I'm sorry, continue.
Oh, Arbe being because Ray has this incredible AA, and that would be a great way to defend your team, maybe even trick Nikki to shoot you with the Arbe, get that extra damage in on Team 99 Cents, just get that extra damage in and, you know, progress your push and all that.
Canola is actually going to take two fists right there as he's going to be stunned out. But we're going to see Burry start the engagement and the Blessing drop. Bad Joe is going to get thrown, and here we see up top, we're going to see Bad Joe go down to the entirety of 99 Cents as Team Boss was separated there by 99 Cents and able to pick up a kill on Bad Joe from that displacement of the throw coming out on Whoopi. An Evil Soldier going to be in the top section right now as we're going to see this engagement start off again. Cannoli is going to be taking a lot of damage right now. Cannoli is going to go down to Whoopi right there. This should be the third turret coming down in favor of 99 Cents as 99 Cents is going to go into the core section and see if they could do some damage. Whoopi's kind of just standing there looking at maybe see if he could get in, and we're going to see a lot of core damage come out right now in a very short amount of time. The engagement start by Burry, but the Evil Soldier there to be that defenseman and really just push Team Boss back into their core section and back to retreat and kind of clear up. But now we're seeing this bottom lane be pushed in by these droids. That's a lot of damage coming out on that bottom turret by a few droids, and a lot of upgrades coming out for a lot of team for the entirety of 99 Cents.
Yeah, Ayla just spent almost 600 Solar, so it's dangerous. That's we're gonna see some magic here, I'm sure.
We're actually going to see Bad Joe and Burry look to set something up here as Cannoli is just going to dash in every now and then and see if he could kind of pick something up right off the bouncer. A snipe hit coming out is going to hit Burry from Nikki as Evil Soldier looking to be that defensive man again. And I think Team Boss is going to collapse in on this top section very shortly.
They do have to point out, I do have to point out that the bottom turret is almost gone, and so is Cannoli.
And Cannoli actually, as you said, he does get picked up. We're going to see Evil Soldier looking for the kill with Whoopi right now. And the nice Genji cocoon is going to be able to thwart him off. But Nikki into the fray right now, battling it out right there. He is going to be able to pick up Furry, but it looks like he is going to go down to Bad Joe from the DOT. Unless he can kind of get that regen going. And he does get the regen going. And Bad Joe looking to defend even more right now against Whoopi. As Whoopi is going to be assaulting him, keeping him in that area, allowing his droids to keep it pushing in. And Bad Joe taking a lot of damage from both members of 99 Cents. That being Nikki and Whoopi, all members. That is the fourth turret down, and they're going to proceed into this final section right now where they're going to try and secure this win as Cannoli's trying to defend along with Bad Joe. The throw coming out, Cannoli getting stunned out of his dash, and that is going to be a victory for 99 Cents as they are going to be able to pick up the win.
Oh, wow. That last push was amazing.
I think both of these teams played very well. But unfortunately for Team Boss, 99 Cents was overpowering in the end, and Ayla.
Oh, yes.
Tell me about this Ayla and how powerful it was in this game.
Yes, Ayla was what you'd say the garbage man. You take out, you get everything thrown at you, and you just get that through the system. Ayla just did all the finishing work, and she did it with brilliance. That was really good Ayla play here. You get the throw in, you make sure you're always in the path of the enemy escape, you will never want to chase, always be ahead of your enemy, and with that size upgrade you can do that very well as land that evil eye slow after the throw. Again, you're not going anywhere, you're going down, that's where you're going. And you know, that has so much damage, and the comp of 99 Cents really accommodated Ayla very well. We've been talking a lot about Skulldeer in this comp, but Raylan as well is really a good complement to Ayla. And I'm sure a lot of people will agree when I say that, you know, their abilities sort of intertwine in the way that you can really use both skill sets from Ayla, the Evil Eye and the Rage Mode, with Raylan's Snipe and Timer. They work really well together. You have the poke and you have that high DPS.
As you said, both of those abilities in both teams and both compositions work very well together. They have great synergy together. That being said, we are going to take a short break and we'll be back with our third match of the day, which is going to be BBQ versus Chocotan, I believe.
Yes,
that
you
being said,
correctly.
We will be right back.